सदाशिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा स्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमोद्व्याप्तदेहाय लक्ष्मीनामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणुजातिगुणेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकं संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। अंतरा भूत ग्रामवत स्वात्मनः। दिस इज व्हाट वी सॉ इन द लास्ट पार्ट द सूत्र, विच मीन्स दैट जस्ट लाइक द आत्मा इज द इनर मोस्ट, बाय ग्रेडेशंस वी सी पंचमहाभूतास बीइंग इंटीरियर कंपेयर्ड टू अदर्स। देयर इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ going within, and then the sarvantaratma, atma which is the innermost brahma, which is karana, sukshma and interior to all the mahabhutas. So when you come to atma, brahmatma proper, then it is antara to all the bhutagrama, panchamahabhuta samuha. Similarly, swatmana antara bhutagrama vat swatmana antara आमननात् मीनिंग सर्वांतरत्वेन आत्मनः एकत्वात् विद्यायाः एकत्वम्। द विद्या इज वन। व्हाट पूर्व पक्षी सेइंग विद्या भेदे विद्यायाः वेद्य वेद्य अभेदे अपि विद्या भेदः, मीनिंग विद्या अभेदः नास्ति इज द पूर्व पक्ष। वेयर एज सिद्धांती सेइंग no, there is no bheda in vidya at all, because this atma which is taught across all vidyas is innermost to everything. So let's look at the vritti, it will be clearer. Atra purva pakshe mitho dharmanu anupasamhara, dharmanam anupasamhara, mitaha, mitaha meaning mutually there is no upasamhara of dharmas across these vidyas. Siddhante tu उपसंहार इति फलभेद। वेर एज सिद्धांति सेज दैट दिस गुण धर्म उपसंहार शुड बी डन। व्हाट इज द एग्जांपल मंत्र देयर बृहदारण्यके यत् साक्षात् परोक्षात् ब्रह्म यः आत्मा सर्वांतरः इति द्विराम्नायते। सो यू सी यत् साक्षात् अपरोक्षात् ब्रह्म, सो देयर ब्रह्म इज इन द मीनिंग ऑफ परमात्मा आत्मा, एंड यः आत्मा सर्वांतरः दैट इज अनदर आत्मा, मेंशन ऑफ वर्ड आत्मा देयर। So there, Brahma which is in the meaning of Atma, Brahmatma, Paramatma, and Atma which is also in the meaning of Brahmatma, Paramatma, both statements are made as in twice there is an utterance of Atma. Iti dvihi amnayate. Twice it has been mentioned, Atma Shabda. So a Sakshat here means this sakshat aparokshat. Sakshat is fine, aparokshat panchami is aparoksham ityartha. So yat aparoksham, sakshat aparoksham, that is brahma, and then that which is sarvantara is atma. Lakshana is twofold now, that which is aparoksha is brahma, sakshat aparoksha, and that which is innermost to everything, sarvantara, that is atma, paramatma. So now this brahmatma which is aparoksha and this Atma which is mentioned as being Sarvantara, is there a Mithaha Dharma Anupasamhara or not? Should you club them together or not? Tatra kim anayoho brahmanayoho vidyabheda, and this has been clubbed together here. If you see, there are different brahmanas in Brihadaranyaka where this mention is there. So you can take it as wherever there is a mention of Atma, and it is differentiated from the earlier mention of Atma. Should you club them together or not? That is the perspective really. So tatra kim anayo brahmaneyo, the brahmanas which are being discussed there, which discuss Atma. So here brahmana dvaye, currently only two brahmanas are there, dvihi amna ayate. Should you club them together or not? Uta vidya ikimiti vishe, vidya bheda iti, purva pakshaha. So purva pakshi says that there is vidya bheda, whereas siddhanti says siddhantastu amananath iti padasya anushanga. You have to bring this amananath from the earlier 34th sutra to this 35th sutra, and then shruti says so. When you do this anushanga, when you bring this anuvritti of amananath, then the swatmanaha antara amananath will be the hetu, and thereby the bhuta gramavat example can be used and said that because Shruti says so in this manner, as Atma is interior to everything, and it is so when you compare the bhuta grama pancha mahabhutas also. So amannat iti padasya anushangaha kartavyaha. Brahmanadvayapi swatmanaha sarvantaratva amananat vidyaikyam iti vidyayam. In both the brahmanas where yat sakshad aparokshad brahma ya atma sarvantara is heard, in both these cases there is meaning. Elsewhere also you find a statement. So when you find such statements in different brahmanas also, there is vidya ikyam. The vidya which is taught is the same. So thereby the ushasta and the kahola brahmana. So the kahola brahmana in the Brihadaranyaka and ushasta brahmana both talk about atma in various ways, as we see here, yat sakshad aparokshad brahma elsewhere yaha atma sarvantara. So twice you hear this, but then you have to differentiate, otherwise there is punarukti dosha. So is the vidya same or not? So siddhanti says the vidya is same. Brahmanadvaye api swatmanah sarvantaratva amananat vidya ikyamiti vidyayam. If you look at the context and apply the Shadlingas, Tatpare Lingas, then you see the Tatpare Vishaya in both Brahmanas is same, and yet Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma ya Atma Sarvantara, it is discussing the same thing in both cases. The revealed Brahma is one and the same. So Ekasmin Dehe Dvayoho Mukhyataha Sarvantaratva Yogat. So if you see this Brahma who is Sakshad Aparoksha and Atma who is in everything, would mean if you differentiate as to Vedya being different, then you have an issue as to Vedya being different. There are two entities. If you say Vedyas are different, but the Vidyas are, Vedya is same, but Vidya is different, then also you have to differentiate what is the Vidya about. If that Vidya is not about Ekameva Dvitiya Brahma, then you will have to say there is a second entity. And if you say there is a second entity, Sarvantaraha and Aparoksha, these are two different entities, then Ekasmin Dehe Dvayoho Mukhyataha Sarvantaratva Ayogat. There cannot be the innermost which is twofold in a single Deha. The innermost has to be only one. See, why should the innermost be one? The innermost ruler cannot be two, it has to be one. Finally, one has to take a decision. Otherwise, as we have seen in Vichara Sagara, as to if there is more than one Atma really, then what happens is that the decision of both cannot be same all the time. Sometimes it may be same, most of the times also if it is same, if you find even a single instance where the decision of two Atmas are different, two rulers, with the example of rulers we are going to take. So if the two leaders agree with almost everything except for one thing also, then the system will fall apart, which is what we see in the political scenario also. There has to be a single leader. So here Atma, if the Atma who is associated with the Sharira is twofold, there are two atmas, then there will be indecisiveness. There won't be such meticulous functioning of the universe. Thereby, mukhyataha sarvantaratva ayoga dvayoho ekasminde in a single body. How? Bhutagramavat. The entire prapancha is meticulously functioning because the innermost ruler is one. It is not that Surya decides one day that okay, today I can go late to the east, I'll go late today in the evening, I'll stay a little more and I'll travel at a lesser speed or whatever. He cannot, meaning, of course, he does not travel, the appearance of the travel that we get. So Surya cannot decide like that. From the perspective of the Surya, if you think, Surya is stationary, all right. But then we say that Suryodaya and Suryasta, that in that manner, Surya cannot influence the universe in such a manner that he appears to stay longer or shorter duration. Based on his whim, based on his whims, he cannot act in that manner. Similarly, Vayu cannot decide one day that, okay, today I'll relax, Vayu Devata. So, all of these are functioning with a single prodder. That's why Keno Prashna starts with that question. Keneshitam Preshitam Patati Manaha. The mind also functions being inspired and in the presence of whom? That tattva I want to know, is it one or two or many? And if it is one, who is it? So the inquiry is also into that entity who has to be one in the end. Otherwise, all this functioning cannot be there at all. And the way it is in the macro, similar it is at the micro level also. So the way it is in the prapancha antargata sharira also, which makes the adhyatmika sadhana possible, that or adhyatmika activity also possible, that is due to a single entity. There cannot be two. Bhuta gramavat yatha bhuta samuatmaka stula dehe prithivyapekshaya jalamantaram jalapekshaya teja ityadi kramena apekshikam bhutanam antaratvam na mukhyam. So if there is gradation of being within, interior to the other, all that is apekshika antaratva. It is not mukhya, it is gauda. But if you go within, the innermost has to be one. Interior can be one and there can be another also interior to that. Just like the sequence of managers, if there are multiple managers, sometimes what happens is that there are more managers to the team than there are team members. That is possible. That's how the setup is all right. But then finally the multiple managers also finally end up reporting a single manager. So single one who will run the show. So team members also have a hierarchy, seniority. Then you will have the manager who has another manager he reports to and so on. Similarly here, within Prithvi, there is definitely Jala. Within Jala, there is definitely Agni. Agni Tattva, within Agni Tattva there is definitely Vayu Tattva, and within Vayu Tattva there is Akash Tattva. But if you go further, Brahmatma is innermost to all of these five, including Akasha. So there are no multiple innermost entities, there is only single Brahmatma Tadvat. Similarly is the case with the Shariras also, at the Adhyatmika level also, when you look at it, what remains when you set aside koshas, that is a single entity. Athava eko deva sarvabhuteshu gudaha ityadi shrutyantare sarveshu bhutagrameshu sarvantara eka eva atma amnayate tadvad anayoho brahmanayo ityartha. So athava has been said, so two interpretations. One is that the swatmana antara amnanat bhutagramat. So bhutagramat you can see like the apekshika antaratvam, or the ultimate antaratvam is also like Bhutagrama, which we have seen in the same interpretation, but it is split in with an athva in the vritti. So two interpretations are possible as to the multiple entities which are discussed. There is a gradation there, that is apekshika antaratvam, just like in Bhutagrama, or there is a single innermost, just like in Bhutagrama. Both ways it is possible. So, athva ekaha devaha sarvabhuteshu gudaha, compared to all the sarvabhuteshu, all the mahabhutas, and in the exemplified you can take bhuta as living beings also. So, there is only a single deva, chaitanya, prakasha, which makes the sharira and the means stula sharira and the sukshma sharira, buddhi ityadi, all the koshas function. And in the case of the example, bhutagramot, all the mahabhutas work and have panchikaranam also, under the influence of which innermost entity that guda hidden in all the mahabhutas also, and he is hidden in all the shariras also, that is one ekaha devaha. Ityadi shrutyantare, this is what you hear in another shruti. So similarly is the case as to the innermost atma being one and the same. So the Shvetashvatara Upanishad is also quoted. Ityadi shrutyantare sarveshu bhutagrameshu sarvantara ekeva atma amnayate. So there is a single atma who is within sarva, sarvantara, who is that actually? Within bhutagrama, one who is there, it is the same entity. Tadvad anayoho brahmaneyo ityartha. So in both the brahmanas, or elsewhere also in other brahmana also, where there is brahma and atma discussed separately, it appears that atma word has been repeated, therefore there should be bheda. Like what? Like the samido yajati, tanuna patan yajati, ido yajati, ityadi mantras. Yajati is same, but the yaga are different. Atma is repeated, but the atma is really different. That cannot be the claim, because here there is Vedya ikyam and Vidya ikyam also. Evancha Vedya ikyat Vidya ikyam iti siddham. The Vedya is one and the same. The knowable entity, the revealed entity is one and the same, Brahmatma. So the Vidya also, even if the methodology differs, it is the same Vidya, says the Siddhanti. So Purvapakshi is saying that even if there is Vidya, Vedya Abheda, there need not be Vidya Abheda that is countered. Just give me one moment, I want to check that. So, see the issue with this Vidya Abheda, whether you, so Vidya Abheda can be Vidya Abheda also and Vidya Abheda also. Padachheda is in both manners based on whether you read an Avagraha or not, meaning Abheda, Savarna Dirga Sandhi or not. So here, Na Vidya Abheda, says the Purvapakshi. Earlier we have seen this Vidya Abheda, Vidya Abheda iti Purvapaksha, there Vidya Abheda is Vidyayaha, Vidyayoho Bhedaha. Here it is Vidyayoho Abheda Na. So the Samasa is split differently. I just wanted to cross check whether in print there is a difference. So in print there is a difference, Vidya, there is a Avagraha here. So Avagraha is good in such cases to avoid confusion. This Avagraha is not there in the case of, in the earlier case. So Yadamananath. So there, in this case there is no Avagraha, but an Avagraha here, Avagraha is good here, so it is better to add. So that is the sutra, first sutra in the 22nd adhikarana, Purvapaksham anudya dushayati. The next sutra in the same adhikarana is introduced by Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra, saying that Purvapaksham anudya, having stated the Purvapaksha, dushayati. Bhagavan Sutrakara refutes that in the 36th sutra, anyatha bhedanupattiriti chennopadeshantaravat. Anyatha bhedanupattiriti chennopadeshantaratvat. Anyatha bhedanupapattihi iti chet na upadeshantaravat. Like the other upadesha, that is an example. You see upadesha elsewhere. So if the Purvapakshi is saying, Siddhanti is answering upadesha antaravat na. What is the objection iti chet, that objection? Anyatha bhedanupapattihi. So he is saying anyatha meaning vidyayaha abhede sati. विद्यायाः विद्ययोः विद्ययोः अभेदे सति इफ दी विद्याज आर आर वन एंड द सेम इफ देयर इज अभेद बिटवीन विद्यास देन भेद अनुपपत्ति दिस भेद व्हाट इज द भेद भेद अभ्यासस्य दिस भेद विच इज रिपीटेड अगेन एंड अगेन दैट भेदस्य भेद अभ्यासस्य अनुपपत्ति दैट वुडंट बी टेनेबल Why? Because you look at it, Atma, Brahma, all these are repeated in various Brahmanas, various Shakhas, variously. That Bheda, just like what? Yaga Bheda created by Yajati. Yajati word being repeated. Similar, this Abhyasa of this Bheda, Atma is this, Atma is that, all this that we hear in Upanishads, that wouldn't be tenable. Iti Chet, if this be the objection, then Siddhanti says no. Why? Because such things are need not be spread across Brahmanas. It can be in the same section also, same Upanishad also, same chapter also. Because you hear the you hear what? You hear Tattvamasi Mahavakya, which we consider as a Mahavakya, 9 times. Navakritta Upadesha. So Abhyasopapattihi Bheda. Bhedanupapattihi, Bheda being repeated is not tenable. To that Siddhanti says, Abheda being repeated will also not be tenable, but it is tenable. Tattvamasi iti upadeshantaravat, like another upadesha of Tattvamasi aikyavakya, that abhyasa upapatti is there, abhyasa is possible. So just abhyasa in Advaita is possible, there is abhyasa possible. In Bheda Vakyas also, or Atma being mentioned in various ways also. It is possible. Anupapatti you cannot say. There is Upapatti. Upadeshantaravat Upapatti ityartha. So, anyata Bheda Anupapatti iti che na. Upadeshantaravat Upapatti hi eva. Bhedasya api Upapatti. This is the... And then, of course, we can always say... Although, I have not read this, but Anyatha Akara is there. Anyatha Abheda Anupapatti can also be read. From Siddhanti perspective, Ekadeshi or someone who can also says Abheda, Bheda and Abheda both are stated. That wouldn't be appropriate if the Vidyas are one and the same. Siddhanti says, no, it is possible. Abheda Anupapatti iti chet, no, Abheda Upapatti hi. Upadeshantaravat. Although it is not mentioned here, I am just saying there is a possibility to read in that manner also. And still explain various Purvapakshas and all of them can be refuted with the second split also. Anyatha Vidyabheda Anangikare says the Vritti. So Purvapakshi is saying Anyatha meaning otherwise, if you do not accept Bheda in Vidya across these Brahmanas, then what happens? Amnana Bhedasya Abhyasasya Anupapattihi. So this Bhedasya Abhyasasya Anupapattihi, this Bheda which you see being repeated. So Amnana Bheda has been said. Amnana Bheda means Bheda which is mentioned in the Shruti. Bheda which is in Shruti proper, that will not be right. A single mention would be fine, but why would there be mention of this Atma multiple times in various Brahmanas? So Prayojana Bhava iti chet. No, Anupapatti means Prayojana won't be there. Iti chet no. Siddhanti says, oh, it is not so, you cannot object like that. Why? Upadesha Antaravata. This Abhyasa, Abhyasasya Upapatti, you say that this repetition shouldn't be there. If Vidya Abheda is there, then Vidya Bheda seen across multiple shakas, multiple times, that kind of Abhyasa shouldn't have been there. To that Siddhanti saying, Abhyasasya Upapattihi. Like what? Upadeshantarvat. Anya Upadesha, Upadeshantaram, Tadvat. Like another Upadesha, विच उपदेशा अभेद उपदेश तथा ही यथा छांदोग्ये तत्त्वमसि इति उपदेशे नवकर्तुः अभ्यस्यमाने अपि न विद्या भिद्यते. यू सी दिस अभेदा विच इज टॉट, यू थिंक दैट देर इज भेदा विच इज टॉट अगेन एंड अगेन, विद्या भेदा शुड बी देर, बट अभेदा इज ऑल्सो टॉट मल्टीपल टाइम्स बट देर इज नो विद्या भेद. नाइन टाइम्स इट इज टॉट एंड इन द सिंगल चैप्टर दैट टू. इन दी सिक्स चैप्टर ऑफ छांदोग्य तत्त्वमसि इति उपदेशे नवकृत्वः अभ्यस्यमाने अपि. ऑल्दो दिस महावाक्य इज रिपीटेड नाइन टाइम्स, देर इज नो पुनरुक्ति दोषा बिकॉज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज सेटअप डिफरेंटली, द क्वेश्चन इन द माइंड ऑफ द क्वेश्चनर इज डिफरेंट, देयर फॉर द आंसर, वाइल द आंसर कंक्लूड्स इन द सेम स्टेटमेंट, द examples used and the teaching is with a different procedure. The teaching is the same, conclusive teaching is the same, but the methodology use, examples used are different, and therefore they clarify different doubts in the mind of the questioner, and thereby even if tattvamasi abhyasa is nine times, abhyasyamane api, even if it is being repeated nine times, na vidya vidyate, this aikya which is taught as to what? Tattvamasi Shvetaketo, you are that Brahma, there is absolutely no difference in that teaching. Upakrama Upasamhara, why there is no difference? Upakrama Upasamharayo Avisheshat, because Upakrama and Upasamhara are same. Knowing which single entity everything else becomes known, that Karana is you. Know that Karana is you. This teaching is same across all nine tattvamasi repetition tadvat. Similarly is what? Brahmanadvaya api tadvat. Like that is the case of Atma Shabda in two Brahmanas or elsewhere also. Brahmanadvaya api prashna rupa upakramasya ato anyadartham iti upasamharasya cha avisheshatna vidyabhedaha iti siddham. So prashna rupa upakramasya, the upakrama which is in the manner of a question in both the brahmanas which have gone by as examples in the earlier sutra in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, there ataha anyad artham, anything other than this particular brahma which is being inquired into in the upakrama, in the upasamhara it has been answered, anything other than this is artham, is afflicted, is dukkha rupa, this alone is sukha rupa, therefore there being a vishesha in upasamhara as an answer to the upakrama question, therefore there is vidya abheda and na vidya abheda, there is no vidya abheda between both brahmanas iti siddham, it is established, so thereby this adhikarana is over. The next adhikarana opens up with the वृत्ति पूर्वं यथा अभ्यासस्य आदरार्थत्वेन मतेः ऐक्यम् अवादी. द वे सिद्धांति हैज स्टेटेड एज व्हाट दी विद्या ऐक्यम, दी मतास विच आर डिस्कस्ड अक्रॉस टू विद्यास, दे आर वन एंड द सेम. व्हाई? बिकॉज अभ्यासस्य आदरार्थत्वेन, दी अभ्यास इज इंटरप्रेटेड डिफरेंटली, देयर इज आदरा टुवर्ड्स द अभ्यास as to there is no dosha, dosha drishti is not there, adara drishti is there, it is meaningful. In subtle matters there is repetition needed, shabdata repetation may be there, vidya aikya may be there, but then the way in which it works is different. Thereby although the repetition is there, there is no dosha, there is adara towards such, respect towards such abhyasa, which is the only way to have this jnana. Thereby, matas are one and the same, vidyas are one and the same, this was established. Tatha, similarly what? Vyatihara upadeshasya api adarartatvat matehe ekarupatvamastu iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Purva Pakshi is saying, similarly, let the vyatihara upadesha. Vyatihara upadesha is, vyatihara is, परस्पर एकत्व कथनम्. somewhere you see mutually things are said to be one, meaning in both ways it is mentioned, as in saha asau, yaha asau, saha aham. So both ways it is said. If you look, listen to vakya like sarvam khalvidam brahma, that sarvam, that sarva, all that prapancha, the entire prapancha, the entire jagat is sarvam khalu, indeed that is brahma. But nowhere there is a statement which says brahma is all this. All this is brahma is one directional. What it means is that it has dependent existence. But when there is mukhya aikya, this is bada samanadikaranam, sarvam khalvidam brahma is bada samanadikaranam. But where there is mukhya aikyam, as to what tat tvamasi, tvam tatasi, tarasi, tvam tarasi, both statements can be there. Not in that very fashion and that very Upanishad, it may be elsewhere also. Or somewhere it can be together as to what? Aham saha asau, yaha asau saha aham, which is in Aitareka. So just jump ahead a little. Tadyaha aham saha asau, yo asau saha aham. I am splitting that mantra. Padachheda, padachheda you see. Tadyaha aham saha asau, yaha asau saha aham. Both ways it has been mentioned. So that which I am, that is very entity who is mentioned by that adas, adas saha, adas tat. So tat, tat and tad yaha. So tat shabda, yat shabda, both are used. Then saha is same as tat shabda. Asau is adas shabda. So you see this, and aham is what? Asmat shabda. So you see what has been mentioned is that that which I am, yaha aham, tadyaham, that which I am, saha, that is that very entity, brahma, and then that which is yaha asau saha, and that which is that very entity in shastras, saha aham. Yaha asau saha aham, that is me. So if you set aside this tat first and just see yaha aham saha asau and yaha asau saha aham, both ways it is there. That which, so that is, if you simplify it, that I am and I am that, in both ways it has been mentioned. So what is the Purva Pakshi saying now? That I am that. These kind of statements are heard in Aitareka Upanishad. What about those statements? Should you split them or should you club them together as a single way to understand? Single vidya. So, tatha vyatihara upadeshasya, meaning paraspara ekatva kathanasya upadeshasya api adarathatvat. There is adara there, meaning it is not a repetition. There is bhinna shabdas. So there is no dosha also. You say, I am that, that I am. There is no dosha there. The phrase itself is different. But if you do anvaya, the phrase is same. Saha aham saham or aham saha aham saha. Anvaya you do. In Sanskrit, you can, in Sanskrita, you can read it in any which way. So there is repetition also. But while chanting, there is no repetition. If you do anvaya, there is repetition. So do you see dosha or not? Or do you see adarartha? Or do you see vidya bheda? Do you see vidya bheda? What is the case there? This is how the Purva Pakshi is bringing up the context. And he says, tatha vyatihara upadeshasya api adarartatvat. He says that that repetition is in adara, there is no dosha there. We are not saying there is dosha, but he says, similar to your interpretation, there is no dosha, there is no vidya bheda also, there is vidya aikya. So here also, adarathatvat matehe ekarupattum astu. Let the vidya be one and the same. And if you say vidya is one and the same, if you club together, there is only single kind of a vritti, single thinking. There is, which can is possible even sarvam khalvidam brahma also. Finally, you land on a single understanding, one way or the other. Saham or aham sa, because both are for adara एंड इट मीन्स ओनली आई एम दैट और दैट आई एम, वन ऑफ द टू यू कैन टेक. द सेकेंड इज आदर अर्थ, देन इट विल मीन वॉट लाइक सर्वम खलविद ब्रह्म, देर विल बी अ सिंगल वे ऑफ इंटरप्रिटेशन, देर नीड नॉट बी बोथ वेज. बट सिद्धांति सेज दैट यू नीड बोथ वेज बिकॉज देर इज मुख्य ऐक्य, दैट मुख्य ऐक्य इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय सीइंग द अदर वे ऐक्य ऑल्सो. दिस इज द सिद्धांतिस पर्सपेक्टिव रियली. सो इति दृष्टांत संगत्या इदमाह पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग यू क्लब देम टुगेदर एंड हैव अ सिंगल अंडरस्टैंडिंग, आई एम दैट और दैट आई एम, विच एवर यू प्रिफर यू कैन कीप दैट, बट इट इज अ सिंगल यूनिट ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग, लेट इट बी सो. देर बाय व्यतिहाराधिकरण सूत्र कम्स अप एंड भगवान सूत्रकार से व्यतिहारो विशिमशन्ति ही इतरवत, व्यतिहारो विशिमशन्ति ही इतरवत. सो व्यतिहारः व्यतिहारः वी सॉ दैट परस्पर एकत्व कथन, व्हाट अबाउट दैट व्यतिहार विशिमशन्ति. विशिमशन्ति विशेषेण उच्यन्ते, द विशेष हैज बीन मेंशन्ड, देयर इज अ स्पेसिफिक मैनर इन विच द ज्ञान हैज टू टेक प्लेस हियर, सो द वे इट इज चैंटेड इन दैट मैनर यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. तद्यहम सह असौ, यह असौ सह अहम, इन बोथ वेज इट हैज टू बी अंडरस्टूड बिकॉज दैट इज अ विशेषण. विशिमशन्ति मीन्स विशेषेण उच्यन्ते, इट हैज बीन स्पेसिफिकली मेंशन्ड इन दैट मैनर बाय द श्रुति, देयर इज अ पर्पस टू इट. यू कैन नॉट जस्ट सेट असाइड द पर्पस सेइंग दैट ओ द कंस्ट्रक्ट इज इन दिस मैनर, वी डू नॉट consider the construct as a necessary mandatory way to understand, but we take that as adhara artha and then we do the anvaya and understand, and when we understand, if we see repetition, that repetition you set aside, you understand in only one manner, that is sufficient. He itaravata, indeed it is so, because you see other places also itaravata, elsewhere also you see such statements, they are all for upasana. In upasana, if the statement is made in a particular manner, then you have to take it in that manner. In Smartha Granthas also, if you see, dhyana is mentioned in a particular manner for a particular sahasranama ityadi, then the dhyana has to be in that manner only. Therefore, the Gayatri Dhyana, Shrauta, upasanas also have a particular way of dhyana, upasana. The upasana has to be in the same manner. You cannot differentiate the upasana by anvaya and say, okay, I understand in this manner, I'll do it in this manner. Mantra also, the mantra has to be chanted in Vaidika karma. Then there is adrishta phala. Mantra which says, you do achamana now, or this is how you cut the piece of grass. Darbha has to be picked in this very manner. That chanting is also to be done while picking the grass, while picking the darbha. Mantra has to be chanted saying that the calf has to be separated using this very shakha. That shakha, when it is that shakha, ishetva ityadi mantra, where the shakha chinatti, when the shakha is broken to create a stick using which the calf is, you know, very mildly pushed aside from the mother while drinking the milk, and that milk has to be used for yaga, not any milk, that milk, and that milk which has to be drawn from the cow, milk from the cow, only by separating the calf which is drinking the mother's milk, and that calf is separated using this very strict by chanting this mantra then. And this mantra has to be chanted while cutting the shakha also to make that stick. So wherever such mantras are mentioned, those mantras are to be repeated there in that very fashion. It is not that you bring some vritti etc. All that is that kathana, in understanding, all that can be there, but then you cannot discard the mantra. You cannot chant the mantra any which way. You cannot compromise the swara. So there is a particular paddhati to follow. That paddhati has to be retained across upasana also and across vidya also, jnanakanda also. Finally, in manana you can differentiate, but in shravana, this is the order. Manana also, in that shabda order itself it will take place, because final karana for jnana is shruti itself, the shabda, which is shrotrendriya sabbaddha, as we have seen in vichara sagara. So you look at it, this mahavakya also has to work in that manner. This is a mahavakya, soham aham saha ityadi. Therefore he itaravat, elsewhere also you see in which manner the mantra occurs, in that manner it has to be chanted, it has to be understood. Mimamsa also has to take place in the same manner. So here in the jnana kanda also the process is similar, says the sutrakara. Vritti says atra purvapakshe matehe aikya rupe laghavam, siddhante matehe vairupe vyatihara sarthakyam iti phalabhedaha. Purvapakshi says that there is a laghava, there is a shortcut method of avoiding all this vyatihara. What you can do is that the mati is one and the same. The buddhi which is born, mati, the understanding that takes place is one and the same with whether it is be yaha aham saha aso or yaha aso saha aham. He says the mati, the vritti which takes place is one and the same in both statements. So you club them together into a single mati, single buddhi, single understanding. That is not true, says the siddhanti. Siddhante mate he vairupya. When the mati, vrittis are considered, understandings are two units, then you see mukhya ikyam, thereby vyatihara sarthakyam, the mutual oneness in both ways is siddha. That is mukhya ikyam. Which is brahma, that is atma. That which is atma is brahma. So you don't have to discard anything there. There is nothing to discard there. That which is atma is definitely brahma. That which is brahma is definitely atma. Meaning it is one and the same entity. Whereas in sarvam khalvidam brahma vakya, where there is no brahma is sarva, brahma has not become this prapancha. This prapancha is an appearance of brahma. Therefore you set aside nama rupa. Nama rupas are not there. Nama rupe nastaha, what remains is what? Satchidananda brahma. Asti bhati priyam is what remains. That is brahma. So this is bada samanadikar. This bada samanadikaran is possible there where you have only single directional oneness. Where you have both directional, you cannot do that. In both directions it has been mentioned, therefore it is mukhya samanadikaran. It is the same entity which is called as brahma or atma. So brahma is atma, paramatma is atma, atma is paramatma. Atma, paramatma has as though become atma, and atma is none other than paramatma. That is the mukhya samanadikaran. Thereby vyatihara sarthakyam, this paraspara kathana samarthya will be there only if you take this mati as twofold, the way it is stated, as to I am that, and also another understanding that I am. Then it will become a complete unit as, oh, if both are, both ways there is oneness, then it is one and the same entity. Tadyo aham aitareyake shruyate, tadyo aham soasau yuvasau soham miti. We saw this, so I'll move ahead. Tatra kim vyatiharina matihi ekarupa vidiyate uta dvirupeti vishaye ekarupaiti purvapakshaha. Whether the understanding is single fold or two fold, purvapakshi says it is single fold. Siddhantastu vyatihara atra upasanartham upadishyate. It is an upasana in which manner it has to be done, that has been mentioned. So you think that upasanartham, for upasana you think as to what? Brahma, I am Brahma. So both ways you have to do upasana. Itaravat, just like it is so in other cases also. Yatha itare sarvatmatvadayaha gunaha upasanartham upadishyante tadavat. So I am the atma of everything. I am the very swarupa of everything. I am present in everyone. This is also upasana, nirguna upasana. It can be saguna also. So these gunas or dharmas which are taught elsewhere, they have to be followed in the very same manner. In jnana kanda also, it has to be understood in the same manner. And here, particularly in this jnana kanda upanishad also, there is an upasana. So this is upasana. So for upasana it is taught, tadyo aham so asau, yo asau so aham. In puja also we have, in smartha puja you have what? Soham bhavina pujayet. And thereby you end up doing what? For each and every deity, you chant a mantra and do anganyasa, karanyasa, ityadi. So the deity is invoked within you. एंड सोम भावे ने पूजेत. इमेजिन यूर सेल्फ इन दैट मैनर एंड देन यू डू द पूजा. सो देर इज नो भेद बिटवीन द पूजा कर्ता एंड दी पूजित डीटी एट ऑल. सोहम भावेन पूजेत सह अहम इति भावेन पूजेत दैट आई एम दैट भगवान मैनिफेस्ट हियर एंड आई एम जस्ट प्लेइंग माय रोल इन दिस मैनर एज अ वर्शिपर. सो इट बिकम्स एन उपासना ऑल्सो देर. सिमिलरली इज द केस तद्वत तथा ही विशिमशन्ति समामनातारः त्वम अहम अस्मि अहं च त्वमसि इति उभयोच्चारणेन. सो यू सी एल्सवेयर ऑल्सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज देयर. दैट इज द केस हियर एज वेल. त्वम अहम अस्मि अहं च त्वमसि. आई एम यू, यू आर मी इति उभयोच्चारणेन. दिस इज हाउ देयर इज अ चैंटिंग इन द उपनिषद एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग उपासना एज वेल अंडरस्टैंडिंग टेक्स प्लेस इन दिस मैनर एंड देयर बाय दिस ऐतरेय मंत्र इज सार्थक. This is the meaning also. Meaning also can be understood in this manner. Iti ubhay uchcharanena, thereby mantra is also there. Tachya visheshanam dvirupayam matau kartavyayam arthavad bhavati. Kartavyayam satyam. When you understand in both manners mati. So mati is showing understanding. And upasana also has been mentioned. In both cases, whether it is upasana kanda kind of a following or jnana kanda kind of following, when you do it in that manner, as in kartavya, this is how it has to be understood. It is how, this is how the upasana has to be done. In both cases, what happens? Arthavat bhavati, it becomes meaningful. Anyatha hi idam visheshana ubhaya amnanam anarthakam syat. Otherwise, there would be no meaning in shruti stating it in both manners. It is not adharartha. Just like in the earlier case, we have seen, although vidyaikyam is there, Navakrutto Upadesha has differences in apeksha and methodology. Similarly here, this methodology is different. This is how it has to be. In both manners it has to be understood, or upasana has to be done in both manners. Then only it will be sarthaka, otherwise it will be anarthaka. Anarthakam syat. Visheshana hi idam. This visheshana ubhayamnanam. Ubhayamnanam means in both manners being stated. That I am that. It would be meaningless. Ataha mati hi dvirupa evaiti siddham. Therefore, the understanding mati as well as upasana is twofold. This is established and conclusively established. So, thereby the adhikarana is over. We look at the next adhikarana in the next part. Amna yantika samsiddham adhimadhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyotir upasmahe. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Namaste.